sallallahu alayhi wasallam regarding the وعن سعيد قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول من تصبح بسبع تمرات عجوة لم يضره ذلك اليوم سم ولا سحر متفق عليه وعن عائشة رضي الله عنها أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن في عجوة العالية شفاء وإنها ترياق أول البكرة رواه مسلم. The first hadith, Sa'id radiyallahu anhu narrates that he heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, if anyone begins his morning by having seven ajwa dates before eating any other thing, then poison or magic will not harm him that day. On the authority of Aisha radiyallahu anha, who has narrated that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, surely in the ajwa dates of Aliyah there is a healing, and they are an antidote against poison if eaten first thing in the morning on an empty stomach. So these two hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they describe many benefits of dates, and specifically the ones that are known as ajwa dates. Now there are different categories of ajwa dates, and as the narration mentions, the benefit of both of these dates, the ones which are grown in Aliya, and Aliya it's an Awali, it's an area, a tribe used to live during the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Muhaddithun, Imam Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, has mentioned in Fath on the commentary of Sahih Bukhari that this specific tree of the date of Ajwa, which is located in Aliya, this was the one that was placed and put by the hand of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's why this gives that significance. However, if a normal ajwa date is eaten for the same purpose, it also suffices, because the other hadith talks about the ajwa dates on his own, not the one which are grown in Aliyah. And that's why you will see in a lot of the ajwa date packages, they will say awali or non-awali. So the one which are awali, this is the one that is mentioned in the hadith as the high quality and high priority dates. But then if you have a normal ajwa date, that also suffices and gives the same benefit. Now, if ajwa dates that is not grown in Medina, it's grown somewhere else, would this has the same effects? The muhaddithin, they go into an agreement regarding that this is only the ones that are grown in Medina, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had made special dua for the dates of Medina to bring these two qualities. So in reality, these two things against, you know, there might be some effects that are found scientifically in these dates of Ajwa that are effective towards the antidote or poison or sihr. But the reality of the Ajwa dates which are found in Medina, they are the one that the Prophet ﷺ himself has made dua. And then the number is also mentioned in how many a person should eat, and that number is seven. Every morning before eating anything, as the hadith of Sahih Muslim describes, that seven dates of Ajwa, they are protection from many type of diseases, as been mentioned in different narrations of the Prophet ﷺ. In fact, the narration of Imam Tirmidhi Sunan, it is that the Ajwa dates is one of the dates that Allah has sent into this world, that is the date of Jannah. So that's why this date has been given that significant. However, these dates are something that was in the practice of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to eat, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam recommended for the Sahaba to eat. So having to be in that practice, this is the sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if a person is able to regularly practice this. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the understanding and the, you know, effects of sunnah in our life. Yes, doctor. So you look for ajwa awali. That's the high quality, the supreme quality dates. Ajwa awali. But if you can't find the ajwa awali, or they're very expensive, because it's, you know, if you're finding like a pound for about $19, $20 for a regular ajwa, ajwa awali will be something like $30, $35. For that same. So this is high premium quality dates. So you look for Ajwa Awali. Other than that, regular Ajwa is also fine. Inshallah. Jazakallahu khairan.